Hey, this is Anthony from RevZilla. You can watch, decide, and ride. Welcome to our detailed breakdown of the new Dainese Centauri GTX boot, available at RevZilla.com. New for the fall of 17 and introduced as part of what Dainese would call its cold weather or winter collection, this is the Centauri GTX. And ultimately, the Centauri GTX is a replacement for the long-running Karamato. Now, we love the Karamato. It was a Gore-Tex boot, it was beefy, it means tank in Italian. What I like that they've done here is now we're gonna call it the European tank. So while it still carries that tech centricity, it's ultimately a bit more svelte, it's a bit more streamlined, it's still a full-grain leather, four-season, in my opinion, hardcore adventure boot. And one of the things that I tie in really quickly is that this sole is beefy. It's Skywalk, but it's an 8 out of 10 on the stiff scale. But if we look at it quickly, it's now lower profile, a little bit more streamlined. They've refined the bellows. They've added some comfort features along the back that I'm gonna get to in a second. And my favorite thing they've changed, which also carries a nitpick, is now I have alloy buckles. So when you go from the high threes into the low fours for a four-season, waterproof, breathable, guaranteed for life Gore-Tex boot, I want to see metallic buckles, and I'd love it even more, Dainese, if you're listening, if these were replaceable. Because ultimately, if I'm going to put the wear and tear that I want to put on these boots, over time, I'm going to want to be able to replace certain things, keep them riding stronger, longer, and keep this boot a little bit more heirloom feeling, lasting me a multitude of seasons versus blowing through those buckles and having to get a new pair. So keep that in mind when you're looking at it. From a fit scheme, and again, thinking about this with a bigger sock in all season riding scenarios with that Gore-Tex waterproof breathable liner carrying that CE rating. From a fit scheme, I don't run out of room. I'm fine through my anatomical American style footbed. It's plenty wide enough without being overly wide. The only thing I'm really gonna call out, you can use the size chart, it's pretty simple, is that remember, this is super stiff. So you're thinking about it, it's more of that fitment, more of that comfort as it ties in with size. But if you want to get off your bike and you want to walk around a ton during the day, if you're doing a lot of touring, which is going to making frequent stops, and potentially doing some off-the-bike walking, this boot's going to get really stiff really fast, and you're going to really feel that. So keep that in mind. Remember, we'll ship free over 39 bucks, and I'd love it if you click our logo, subscribe to RevZilla on our YouTube channel. Leave me your comments, your questions, your feedback on the new Centauri GTX. So all in, we did see a price increase. We saw it go up from the high threes into the low fours. Little bit of an increase, but the big thing I'm gonna home in on quickly is they've beefed this boot up differently. So again, I still have my ankle cockpit here, which gives you that lateral and medial side protection, but now there's added padding on the inside, so it's gonna be a bit more comfortable. If we look at our toe box, again, very, very simple, but very much carrying a stiffness rating and a premium level of protection, again, to tie in with that CE rating. You're still getting your TPU around the heel, creating that cockpit. Again, these are the features you want, and ultimately, they've streamlined the shin protection, but is a thermoformed shim that lives within this, so you do have a hard part protector. It's not just embossed leather. Keep that in mind. There is a beefiness and a quality to that. Also note, this is one of the boots in the touring collection from Dainese that's sticking with its full grain leather, which has a better breathable quality. And it's going to go over top of that Gore-Tex waterproof and breathable, you know, really the highest degree of waterproof breathable membrane that's going to be baked into this boot. So again, your full grain leather, you do have some areas that are beefed up, like on the lateral side of the toe, which is full grain leather, dual recess stitching here in our shift panel, which you're going to see on both sides of the boot. Ultimately, the sole is a Skywalk sole. We've talked twice about the stiffness, so I'll let that go for now. But if we look at it, multiple durometers, multiple texture patterns, whether you're standing on the pegs or you're actually walking, depending on how you ride. Again, giving you that flexibility, even if your foot has to go down on a trail. That remember, this is a boot built for gnarlier four-season conditions. Really some more lightweight to more hardcore dual sporting, although I'm not going to go as far to say it's a full off-road boot. If we move to the instep and the elasticated bellows, the previous version of the Karamato, these were big and beefy. They were a little bit over the top. They were a little bit too space odyssey. Dainese streamlined and trimmed them down. They're now a bit suede or more of a split grain leather. And again, they're refined. They're a little bit more flexible. They're going to work with you a little bit more. Split grain leather along the inside. Note the heat shield factor here. Also great from a grip standpoint against the bike if you're standing on your pegs. And then also on the medial side of the heel, notice we have our hard part protector baked in. And just like the lateral side, upgrade to the Centauri over the Karamato is beefed up padding on the inside, so it's a little bit more comfortable against your skin. You do have a little bit of a texturized, rubberized grip panel here in the back. Again, all about creating a good tactile area for response and contact when you are standing on the pegs. And then the back side of the boot, I wish we had a little bit more reflective, but we do have a pop down here on the back side of the heel cockpit. You can see it right there. and then the back has been refined, and there's another area of elastication and flex here that's a little bit less stiff. It was previously more leather, again, against the backside of your Achilles, depending on how you're built. This is gonna come into play and it's gonna make it more comfortable. Now, if we open up the boot, like I said, I wanna see replaceable buckles, but I'm very happy that they've gone the way of alloy. Micro Velcro, if we open it up, there's our waterproof, breathable Gore-Tex gaiter. It goes up and it stops right there. And then along the top, you're going to notice this is more of that lightweight mesh material to really wick sweat away, wick it away from your calf out through that Gore-Tex liner, allowing it to evaporate and keep you cool. The last thing you wanna do is get sweaty and clammy, or depending on if you're riding in the rain, have your foot really turn into that trash bag effect. And ultimately, there are a lot of waterproof, breathable liners out there. D-Dry is one. That's Dainese's own proprietary waterproof, breathable liner. But really where Gore-Tex shines is the fact that it's more pores per square inch. And remember, those pores allow water vapor out by way of evaporating sweat, but they don't allow any moisture in or precipitation in. So full downpour, full road riding, 60 plus miles an hour for an extended period of time, this boot will not get wet. You will stay comfortable, you will stay dry. Again, that's the gold standard of Gore-Tex. And these days in motorcycling, you're typically spending north of the $350 mark if you want to get Gore-Tex mixed with CE-rated level of technicality on a full-height boot. Now, the next step in your journey is to click the info button, your desktop, your mobile device. Visit the product detail page at RevZilla.com. Read other rider reviews on our Centauri GTX here, new from Dainese. As always, we'll ship for free over $39. If you want to talk to a gear geek, see us at RevZilla.com or 877-792-9455. Thanks for watching our detail breakdown. Remember, subscribe to us at RevZilla on our YouTube channel. Stay up to date with our opinion, the latest and greatest in the motor universe. I'm Anthony. We'll see you next time.